Hi everyone and welcome back for today's video. Today we are going to make a marble effect look again on a 50 by 70 centimeter canvas. And today's video is a commission from a dear friend. She had moved and now needed a new painting for her walls and wanted something fitting to the entire design that she's going for the new flat. So the colors that were requested were mostly gold, some burgundy red, and that's practically it. It was a bit of a challenge because the golds were supposed to be the overpowering colors, and to make it not look too boring, I decided to use three different golds. As you can see, each of them looks pretty different. The first one is a Lawrence & Morgan metallic gold paint, which I use often when it comes to metallic paints, but I mostly love their pink and their turquoise color. So the gold is a gold tone, which I do not endorse so much, but I wanted to use it here to give it some contrast. I also use the Artina gold, which you see me using all the time. It is also the most reddish and vibrant color, I would say. Then I use the Arteza gold, which works just as great as the Artina gold. It's a bit of a different color tone, so it's more like a real gold, I would say, so not so much reddish. I used a white, and besides of the white, she also wanted to have some cream color, so like a light beige, I would say, which I used also from Artina. As I'm pretty often asked how I mix my paints, I left this in this video, just in this sped up version. In case you're wondering and have not seen me mixing my paints yet, it is practically always the same mixture that I'm using for over a year now, with whatever colors I use. I'm using an acrylic binder, and for those who do not know what an acrylic binder is, this is the stuff acrylic paints are made of, but without any pigments in there. So it's just like a plain acrylic paint without any pigments. It looks white, but when it dries, it's completely clear. And it is pretty thick, so to speak. It is way, way thicker than the Floetrol is. The good thing on that end, I can thin it down with water pretty much without losing any binding abilities of the acrylic binder, because it's an acrylic binder. So this one is good for two things, because it is way cheaper than the Floetrol, for example, is, and I can thin it down even more, so it's a win-win for me. For those out of Germany and Europe, I'd say, you can check down below my links in the Amazon section. I have also linked the Bösner Gaudi binder, which is the stuff that I'm using. It is available in Germany and all the other countries where Bösner is going to deliver or has their stores. So yeah, have a look and check it out if you can get it. I really recommend it. It works great. I never had any paints cracking or ripping apart since I'm using this. And it's pretty much easy to control the consistency of your paints. Because if it's too thin, you just add a bit more to get it thicker. And if it's too thick, you just add water and do not risk any cracking or ripping in your paints when you use them. Besides this, when your paints are dry, they are super shiny and glossy as if they were varnished already. I do add a coat of varnish, of course, just to protect them anyways, but they look as if they were varnished once they are dry, which is great. When it comes to measurements, I have to say that I never measure anything. I do not really count how much of the binder or the paint I'm using. I just eyeball everything and I more concentrate on the final consistency of the mixture than how much paint or binder there is in. So I always go for a consistency like warm honey. It should run down from your stick in one stream. There shouldn't be any blobs or drippings. And if my paint hits the paint in the cup, it most of times domes up for about half a second and then combines evenly. Sometimes I mix it also as thin that the paint is going to combine right away without doming up. So this is the consistency that I love working with, which works the best for me and my techniques that I'm using. And this is something I would recommend you try to achieve if you want to get the looks that I get in my paintings. I pretty much show everything that I do all the time, so you can follow along and just do the same things that I do and you should be able to achieve the same results. It also of course depends a bit on the colors that you are using, so especially when you use metallic colors, you tend to get cells anyways. the acrylic binder in a way prevents a bit desire creation on its own, which the flow tool, for example, does not do. So if you use flow tool, you're pretty likely to get cells anyway, even if you do not want to get them, because it is just caused by the flow tool. When I do this marble effect on my ring pores, I never add any silicone, unless I tell you. So I never hide anything what I do to my paints. And for this painting here, there was no silicone whatsoever. For some of my paintings, I occasionally use my torch, but this is not to get any cells. This is more for popping any air bubbles that are sitting within the paints. I, until now, pretty much mixed my paints just when I needed them, so I have no pre-mixed versions. I will be pre-mixing my colors for the future and filling them into larger squeeze bottles or so, just to have them prepared to give me some more time, because the paint mixing, as you all know, is pretty time intense. And this also should prevent me having too much air bubbles in my paints, which I, of course, do have when I mix my paints freshly. So this is something I'm going to work for and, yeah, something to address for my future videos. But coming back to the painting itself, and all the paints were mixed, so I hope most of you just listened to me while I was mixing or jumped just to the interesting part, whatever you prefer most. I also added the red in the end, because I totally forgot to mention this in the beginning. The red is mixed from a burgundy acrylic ink, because this was the most burgundy-like color tone that I had available and the most pigmentation. And I added a bit of regular red acrylic paint to it just to give it more pigmentation. And then I filled everything into the cup tool. If you are curious about the cup tool itself, I made a video where I have built it and a couple where I have used it. I will link this in the video here as well. I really can encourage you to try making your cup tool as well. It works great, it's fun to do, and it gives you awesome results. This is the large version. I started out with a 3-cup tool, which is even easier to use, and it's so easy to build. Don't concentrate on cup sizes or anything like that. Just use the cups that you have, glue them together and go for it. So I didn't put any thoughts into my cup sizes myself, so I recommend you don't do as well. Other than that, all the preparation were done and I was just pouring everything onto the canvas that I had here. Again, 50 by 70 centimeters. I made a base layer of white paint just to help the paint flow a bit easier and not to roll over itself too much. And again, it was meant to be like a marble royal look that I was going for. I never before used it for this purpose, and it did turn out a bit different than I expected. I had to tilt it pretty much to get the look that I was looking for, and I did not get the result that I was hoping for. But I liked how it looked like in the end, and when it was dry, which I forgot to film in the end, which I'm really sorry, it looked brilliant. So the red dried much darker than you can see here in the wet version, and the golds also did dry very shiny. I love that I had the three different shades of gold on there. I would have wished to have more of the Artina gold, which was the more reddish, vibrant one. I got more of the Arteza gold and the Lawrence and Morgan gold. Most of the gold on there is the Lawrence and Morgan, which looks more like a muted gold tone and is not as shiny as the Arteza one. Even less shinier than the Artina one. Sorry that they sound pretty much the same. And the good thing with the Artina gold is that it looks 3D when it's layered. So when I have these rings poured with the Artina paint, it looks really three-dimensional when everything is dry, which I only got in a couple of areas here for this painting. But anyways, this was enough packed information for this video. I hope you liked it. If you did so, as usual, please make sure to leave me a thumbs up. Leave a comment if you have any questions or just want to say something to me. And if you are new, this was the first video and you got entertained, I would love if you can click the subscribe button and yeah, follow my channel for coming videos. Also make sure to have a look at the other videos which are already there. There are so many already and I'm pretty sure some of the results are really, really worth looking at. All the materials links that I have used are down below in my video description and also my social media if you want to get in touch with me. If you want to support my channel, you can of course use the affiliate links that I have down there from Arteza or Amazon. And as you might know already, this gives me a small commission when you buy something, but it doesn't have any extra costs for you. If you want to keep exploring my artwork, you can head over to my Etsy store, which you can also find in my video description down below, to see what I have available if you have some spare room on your walls. So thank you so much for your time, thank you for watching, and other than that, I hope to see you on my next video. Have a great day, bye bye.